greetings, and thank you for coming to support us by watching today's video. If you would like to support us even more, you can do so by clicking on the like button, posting a comment down below, and of course, if you would like to see more videos like this, make sure to click that subscribe button. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Like, you're listening to the music and you're thinking to yourself, this sounds very heroic for the fact that we're in a Guardian stronghold. And you're right, it does. But that doesn't mean that the Guardians have not launched an offensive against the Alamegan resistance. And we're here to intervene to deal with both factions. So let us prepare for departure. But here we go, our main story dungeon for patch 3.5, part 1. Will there be another main story dungeon when part 2 comes out of patch 3.5? Who can really say? But now we're going to take on a whole bunch of evil Gronian minions. And this time, they're bringing out the heavy artillery in sky armor. It looks like our tank's going to be pulling big here. And as you can see, I'm being chained. I've been chained by the sky armor. And there's nothing I can do about it. At least there's nothing I can do about it until we actually destroy the damn thing. Thankfully, it's because of the fact that Cynthia's a bard, she can actually attack during the fact that she's mobile. Which is a big help in this place, I must say. But yeah, the music so does not fit this place. It's really cool, but it does not fit this place at all. I mean, it's a freaking Guardian stronghold that has the wrong name on it. It's a freaking Guardian stronghold that has the wrong name on it. There's a healer in the midst of this chaos. Wish I could tell who it is, though. Because I don't see a, healer anywhere. So where's the healing coming from? It's hard to tell from this vantage point. And for those of you who are wondering, yeah, they have brought in guard dogs. They have brought in guard dogs to harass us. Anyone who knows me knows that I have a childhood trauma with dogs. So, anything I can do to help put dogs down, especially evil ones, is fine by me. Yeah, but barking always scares me because you're never ready for it. And it always startles you. So yeah, to say I'm not a fan is an understatement. Yeah, Tank, you can't go any further with this pack. The key is being held by one of these four opponents. And it's the only thing we can use to advance further. They can only advance so far. Can only advance so far with this stuff. Splash on them. There we go. Whoa! Run! Alright. Heal, boy. Let's deal with the soldiers themselves. Time to deal with the soldiers themselves and their craziness. Almost got this pack down. Alright, he drops his key. And it gets used over here. So now we're really going to be moving into the heart of the stronghold. No, it's okay. It's okay there, Tank. You're fine. We still gotta contend with evil sky armor. And there's not just one of them, there's two. I was about to say, where's the tank? Oh, apparently it's attached to him. Okay, he got the thing taken off of him. Or he got it taken off of me. Alright, they're dead. Oh, where did you come from? Let's deal with that, shall we? Yeah, sneaking out from behind. How could you? Yeah, let's do away with your crap. A full thrust will certainly help get the job done. For 5,000 points of damage on you. Alright, caster's down. Now for the melees. Spin to win. And then splash on you. Yeah, we can even see through a gate. We can even see through the gates of this place. Alright, Cynthia opens us the path to mini-boss number one. A Magitek Predator. Right. Here comes Mitri. Who I've noticed has utilized the Fantasia and has changed herself back into a Mikote. Yeah, last time we saw her, she was a Lalafell, but Mitri, of course, being our resident chameleon, has utilized the Fantasia once again. And we got Sky Armor in the field now, we gotta deal with. So we gotta disable these stupid things. And yeah, they treat us the same way as the other Sky Armors did. And look out for that move. Because similar to the battle against Alexander level 12, that thing can't hit in range. It can hit on an AoE if there are people standing too close. Now that we've gotten those guys down for a while, let's deal with this crap. And for those of you wondering, are those Sky Armors going to be back? Well, there's your answer. Yes, they are. Ooh, I took a hit there. And I'm still being attacked by this stupid thing. Yeah, this Sky Armor does not play nice. But given that we're in a patch 3.5 dungeon, it's like, what were you expecting? It's like, what were you expecting? Alright, I need to step away. Because I'm being targeted, and so is Cynthia. We're both going to take massive damage. Thankfully, I escaped that move. Spin through that. Now we gotta wait once again for these guys. Yeah, now it's not just the fact that we're being chained, it's more than that. Alright, oh, he's dead, okay. I didn't notice it first, but we got him. Slow you down a bit. Now let's get back to business. Increase our buffs. And then let's go ahead and let loose the limit break. Was it a good idea? It was. Thankfully we weren't standing too close to each other. Which I am happy to accept. Because yeah, you never know when that's going to give you a bit of frustration. Okay, Sky Armor round 4. Now we're definitely taking our lumps here. Ah! Now we're taking lumps here. I should probably, yeah, save myself with the second wind. That'll be a good idea. Save myself with the second wind would be a really good idea. Oh, congrats there, Lou. But not on your success. Trying to avoid that. So yeah, we won't need to worry about Sky Armor anymore. We've won the fight. That definitely took a lot out of us, didn't it? Filibuster's Belt of Aiming. We obtained? Right, let's move on. Now this part is going to be fun. Moving into the armory, this is going to be quite a thing. We have a control panel here, and it's the only way we can advance further on in this place. So we'll let the tank do what he must. And as you can see, we are now in motion. And this is going to take us on quite a few places. And wherever it stops, it's going to bring out some evil creatures. Namely, these Magitek Slashers. Not much in terms of damage from one, but get a whole bunch involved and you are going to be in trouble. Which is why you really need your AoE moves here, if you have them. If you're a caster, you're in a very good way. But they're not the only things to worry about. We also have Magitek Claws to also deal with. Whoa! Staying clear of that crap. Now to deal with the claw. Yeah, they weren't quite done giving us gifts just yet. Alright, we depart from there. And now we're actually going back the way we came. I don't know why, but that's how it goes around here. But next up, a trio of Magitek Colossi. Yeah, these things do not mess around. Okay, who's being targeted here? It's hard to tell. It's hard to tell who's being the main focus of the attack! Oh, look out for danger! Yeah, this time now, when it comes to dealing with the grand sword attack that Magitek Colossi use, I'm glad that they gave you an AoE tell to let you know to be ready for it. Because it's not something that they've used previously with other variations of the Magitek Colossi and other Guardian Strongholds that we've been to. So the fact that they've done that here in Baelsar's Wall is very nice. Okay, those three Colossi are dead. Now moving on. And we got another conveyor belt over here. And not only are the little guys coming out, but the claw is coming out right out of the gate. But our focus is of course going to be on dealing with this crap. So spamming Ring of Thorns as much as possible. And as you can see, we're going to have more claws coming to play. Yeah, not content with just putting one into play, they're putting in more. And they're coming with AoE aplenty. Making it very difficult to place a Ring of Thorns where you want it to. And as you can see, it really depletes my TP. But it's the sort of thing you have to be willing to do if you want to rid yourself of these little menaces. Okay, this Adamantite Claw is so close to being dead, let's just go ahead and finish it off. But yeah, Cynthia, I need you to implement your AoE attacks, if you could be so kind. Or are you running... Actually, no, you're not. You're at full TP. You don't suffer from this problem like I do. Alright, moving over again. Next up. Three Magitek Vanguards. Yeah, they're going to be bringing the entire cavalry here. Anything that is Magitek, they're bringing to the party. And it's not a pretty sight. And I don't know how I picked up the aggro here. Yeah, it's always confusing when I pick up the aggro, when everyone's attacking, the same thing. Or at least they're supposed to be attacking the same thing, because yeah, we were primarily attacking that one suit of Magitek armor, we were attacking that one Magitek Vanguard, and somehow I got the aggro. Nonetheless, we still killed it off. Just confuses all. Almost got this guy down. There he goes. Oh, I did already play for it. And I'm the one who got it. But now we're free to go. We're done with the crazy gauntlet. So now we ride to boss number 2. Get a quick swig of water before we deal with the armored weapon. Yeah, it's not an ultimate weapon by any stretch of the imagination, but it is by no means weak in comparison. This thing's got a lot of tricks up its sleeve, like this move. So this move you just have to grin and bear it because it causes sick damage. And then diffractive laser on top of that as if you weren't suffering enough. And then showing that it's not completely one-dimensional. Yeah, he brings out friends. He brings out a whole bunch of friends. Because yeah, we haven't had enough to deal with in terms of these magic slashers. Yeah, try and thin their numbers out somewhat. Let's see if I can actually trick this thing. Oh crap, I can't. I think I'm dead. Yeah, I am. I could not escape fast enough, and I stereotyped. Well, that's unfortunate. Yeah, I was thinking to myself, maybe if I don't do anything, I'll get... I'll be fine. But, nope. Yeah, I didn't have that issue previously, but I guess they're not gonna let me get away with it, no matter what. You either deal with it, or you don't. Watch out for this crap. Oh, are you serious? Alright, let's go ahead and launch the limit break, because we do have it now. It doesn't seem to really matter, does it? Like, you have no choice but to move. And I was thinking, like, maybe there's a way to cheat this, but no. You have to take your hit like a man, or woman, because that's just how it goes, unfortunately. Yeah, I'm not afforded the luxury of trying to completely dodge that, because it seemed like one of those moves where if you just stop moving, you'll be fine, but it doesn't work out like that, unfortunately. And now we gotta deal with even more Magitek slashers. We'll cut right through them. Help thin the numbers somewhat. And I guess we'll go ahead and Ring of Thorns them a little. Are you gonna come after me again? Hey, you didn't come after me again for once! But I still got stunned. You didn't come after me, but I still got stunned. Like, I don't know, maybe there's something that I'm missing about that mech. Like, I don't know, Lou, maybe you figured it out. Alright, Magitek bits again. Because we have to be ready when chaos occurs. Thankfully, this isn't on me. Yeah, it seemed like this armored weapon was really fixating itself on me for the longest time. Thankfully, we pulled through. Ooh, free 1,200 plus seals for me. Thank you very much. 1200 plus seals for me, thank you. So now we gotta go up. We're taking a ride on a Praetorium style lift. It is a lot of healing. Which is why you better hope you have a healer who's up to the task, and thankfully we do in Mitri. So now we're getting really into the heart of the fighting. Because yeah, look at this set of enemies that we're gonna have to put up with. Oh, we're just waiting on Cynthia, okay. We were just waiting on Cynthia, that's all crap. Yeah, the moment we make our move, bang, AoE. The moment we make our move, bang, AoE, and I will stereotype myself again. Oh, look out. Twice. But yeah, this place really likes to spam the AoE like nobody's business. Did I get all those guys? I think I did. Or at least the ones that were still standing. Nope, a Magitek Reaper slipped through the cracks. Yeah, my aim was a little off there. Well, he's dead. Now time to deal with the Reaper. Don't fear the Reaper, as Blue Oyster Cult would say. And that Wolfair would spam the cowbell on. Guess what? I got a fever. And the only prescription is more cowbell. Like, I've actually heard that song in its entirety, but most radio stations I've heard who play it don't include the guitar solo that comes after verse 2. They just play with only the verses and not the guitar solo. Because yeah, even though the cowbell may be the most prominent part of that song, as Will Ferrell so clearly demonstrated, it wasn't the only prominent thing about that song. There was a guitar solo in there too. Alright. Hit whenever we can. But yeah, the tank has room to run here. In fact, he's gonna run right into the Alamegan resistance on this. So yeah, we're not only fighting the Guardians, we're now fighting the Alamegans too. At the same time. A freaking chaotic scene here. And somehow we got to thin out both sides. It's not just one faction of people that we got to deal with, it's two. And thankfully, Cynthia is on her game with her AoE. Yeah, she came prepared this time around. But I guess I can't use that stuff all the time. I don't know, I don't have a level 60 bard yet. Don't know how long it will take for me to actually get one though. Ew. Yeah, I was about to say, where do you think you're going there, mister? Or ma'am, or whoever you are. I can't tell from this vantage point. Because the way I see it, you're all Alamegans who are disguised as Eorzeans. And that's pretty much the gist of it. Ed! Staying clear of that crap. Yeah, we're thinning you guys out. Oh, couldn't quite get you killed off, but there we go. There we go. We had you right teetering on the precipice, and then we did away with you. Leg sweep to take out your legs, and the rest of your body for that matter. Ring of aiming, that's not something I need, but I'll play for it anyway. Alright, up we go. Because we've beaten the last wave of enemies, because next up is the final boss. Take a guess on who we're going to be fighting. We found the Griffin. Yeah, standing probably there with his cape and his mask. Yeah, we're looking at you. But he's gonna take his mask off and reveal himself. as Ilbaird of the now-defunct Crystal Braves. Yeah, he was the Griffin all along. Not as if I didn't already know, because I kind of figured it out. Yeah, I already kind of figured out who he was going to be, and a lot of people I spoke with were all in agreement. But yeah, it's Griffin v. Griffin here in the final battle of the main story dungeon of patch 3.5. And since we last fought Ilbaird over in Halotali hard mode when we were trying to save Raoban from being executed by him, Mr. Ilbaird here has picked up a few tricks. Not the least includes flash powder, as we just saw, but if you turn away from that, you won't be blinded.
Sloppy.
And he's talking up a storm. But yeah, when he does this, this is the most important move of the fight, because when he drops all these flaming swords, you need to take it upon yourself to do one thing and one thing only. Destroy one. If you don't destroy a blade in time, your ass is grass and the party will wipe. Oh crap, I've been targeted. Which is bad for me, because if I don't move back in time, I could have been instantaneously killed. But now we gotta run over here quickly!
Sloppy!
Well, in that instance, you were right there. I was sloppy. I didn't react fast enough to your move. Primarily because I've only done this fight once before with Corinne. And yeah, if you think he's just lending himself to that, think again, because he can also immobilize your healer. And it has the similar move that is shown when you do the fight against Gilgamesh for the second time to conclude the Realm Reborn and Hildebrand mysteries. But yeah, he's just jumping all over the place, so you really have to be on your guard and anticipate his moves when the time is needed to do so. I did say he had no shortage of tricks.
I'll tear you limb from limb.
Well, you'll need to do better than that, then.
Sloppy! For Alamigo!
So yeah, once he does Lion's Head, you know that you can expect this move.
I have you now.
Well, you're gonna have to prove it. Thankfully, I had the correct points in the rotation.
How'd you like this?
And we can go ahead and disable. Ah, crap, I got stunned and lost my accuracy. And he's gonna take advantage of this. Thankfully, I do have enough time to get away from danger. But you gotta follow him whenever he does this move.
Sloppy.
And that's pretty much how this fight goes. It's very technical, but once you figure out his patterns and what you gotta do, he's not all that bad. Just be ready to save your healer when the situation requires you to do so. I was about to say, come on, make that one count. Oh, he's gonna jump. Oh, we're on the wrong side. Well, well played there, Mr. Ilbaird. Thankfully, none of us took damage. Which means I can now nail you with a double limit break. Take off 9% of your health.
I'll tear you limb from limb.
Well, then try harder. You talk a big game, but so far you've yet to back it up. And as you pretty much can tell, we're gonna have to go through the burning swords once again.
I have you now.
Alright, get ready to mobilize the central blade.
How'd you like this?
Yeah, we'll burn it for good measure. Ah, crap. And for the third time, I've been targeted by him. Targeted by him for the third time. Well, he knows who's streaming. He knows who's on the air broadcasting this to the world.
Sloppy.
Ironically, he knows exactly who to target. Yeah, he's done this before. Now, I would say I would feel confident about not having to go after the strength color again, but I would rather not risk it. I would rather not take the chance. And I would rather save my healer. Now let's finish him off. Whoa! Yeah, I was completely faked out by that one.
Sloppy.
No, the one who was sloppy here was you there, Illbeard. We win the fight. Yeah, I'm taking my name back. You can't have it, it belongs to me. And we're all gonna stare at you intently. Yeah, I'm taking my name back. Oh, and did we actually get a triple triad card? Well, you may have there, Cynthia. Unfortunately, I did not.